Hi, my name is Antonis and I am the painter of this video. For today I want to share some thoughts of mine while you will see me painting this astonishing portrait of Pope Innocent X, painted by Diego Velázquez in 1650 originally. Pope Innocent X was reluctant to let Velázquez paint his portrait. He wasn't sure that Velázquez was a good enough painter to paint his portrait. But after the Pope saw a portrait of his servant painted by Velázquez, he was convinced that Velázquez was worthy enough to paint his eminence. Is that it? His eminence? Yeah, or his holiness. So you already see me here painting in oil this study, and I have to say that I truly enjoyed painting this. It was very refreshing to use the brush strokes in a way that Velázquez must have used, I'm sure. And this portrait was finished in one sitting, in one session, and I'm pretty sure that Velázquez painted in a very similar way. I haven't seen this portrait from up close in reality. I've just seen its reproductions, but I have seen Las Meninas in Madrid, that amazing painting by Velázquez. It's probably one of the most beautiful paintings in history of mankind, and this portrait of Pope Innocent the X is considered by many as probably the most amazing, let's say, portrait of all time. The more I paint this study, and the more I remember the work of Velázquez, the more I appreciate this kind of painting, and I disregard the photorealistic paintings and drawings that I so often see today in social media. There are many painters who paint an exhausting a portrait with exhausting details, each and every tiny speck of the face. And that's great if you have the time to paint in such a way, or if you are willing to impress your friends about your skills in painting the way a photograph machine, camera can photograph. But apart from that, to me it doesn't really say much. It doesn't really convey anything from the character and the personality of the painter, the view, the gaze of the painter. So it doesn't really, it's not as strong as the painting that where the brush strokes are suggestive, let's say, and with a few brush strokes you can give the illusion and the impression that of a surface, of a material, a texture, etc. Velázquez was a master in doing that. His brush strokes were very bold and very masterfully chosen. I truly appreciated his brush strokes, his work while I'm doing this study. It's when I'm doing these studies, I tend to believe that these painters were gods, or, you know, half gods, but They were humans, and they perfected their technique by a lot of practice, by devoting their life. And that's really something that I've learned from many master painters of the past. They were an example to me of how devoted they were to painting. And it's always moving to me when I'm reading their biography and how they devoted their life to painting, how everything was revolving around painting for them, and how they traveled to study painting in periods of history where travel was very difficult, how many years of their lives they devoted as students, and to me it's really great to study them. And while I'm studying them, not only I learn how they perceived painting and how they conducted themselves as painters, but also I learn technical aspects, some of their techniques or their approach in painting. And I feel that I truly become their student and become better. Here, for example, while I'm painting this terrific portrait of Pope Innocent, I realize that anyone can be a great subject to paint. I see painters today that they choose their models according to their beauty. They have to be actual fashion models to also become painting models, and that's totally not part of what painting is. Anyone with a face can be a model. You can paint the portrait of anyone. There are no interesting faces and boring faces. And you can tell this when you check this very clever looking, shrewd looking face of Pope Innocent X, painted by Velázquez. So, as you see, I follow the teachings of the great master here, and I try to build this portrait using a lot of impasto. It's an alla prima painting, since I will finish this painting in one sitting while all the colors are still wet. And I have to say that at this point of the painting, I really felt very satisfying about the outcome of this painting and how beautiful, well, actually not beautiful, but how the material behaved and moved around by me in a way that was satisfying and somehow obeyed me. So it really felt great. And yeah. So here I'm doing some of the highlights, and pretty much I spend most of the time in this portrait moving the color around and trying to see how I will achieve as much similarity to the painting of Velázquez as possible. These painters like Velázquez, who traveled from Sevilla to Madrid, and from Madrid he traveled twice to Italy to paint in Italy and also study the painters there. Tells me that a painter should always make space for painting in his life, to always decide things based on painting, or taking under consideration what painting is to him or her. And to find some more time during every day to even draw something simple. I was lucky enough to meet a very important a painter in California. Actually, he was a photorealistic painter, but he truly was one of the first ones. He was on the top of his career in the 70s. And I asked for his advice to me as a young painter back then, and he told me to never let a day pass by without draw a single line. To draw something or to paint something each and every day. Of course, I haven't followed his advice exactly, but it's something that I always remember, and I want to always keep that in mind, that a day shouldn't pass without me being a little bit creative. Now, this portrait also comes to its end, and I truly find it interesting and fascinating. The gaze of the Pope is to me very piercing. And I want to thank Diego Velázquez for being my teacher here, and for teaching me so many things while I painted this portrait. I want to thank you for watching this video with me. I really hope you will be inspired to be in your studio and paint more, and to be more creative and healthy, as painting keeps us very healthy. If you want to find the full course of the full lesson and all the technical aspects of this video, I will upload the whole session on my Patreon page on patreon.com, and there are several other posts there, and more are about to be published there. I do hope that you will be inspired. Have a blessed and beautiful week, and I will see you soon with another tutorial. Bye.